What is going on, everybody? It's your boy, Snowbike Mike, back with your After Work Recap for Tuesday, June 18th, 2019. Here are the top gaming headlines that you might have missed while you were at work. Remember, if you like any of the stories that I bring to you today, please go to the articles directly and support those incredible games journalists around the globe. Story links can be found in the show description below, so let's get into it. Here are the top four stories that you need to know about. Story number one, Wolfenstein Youngblood's estimated game length revealed. This story from GameSpot.com by Jeremy Winslow. The story reads, E3 may have ended, but news about the convention's biggest games continue to trickle out. Machine Games executive producer Jurt Gustafsson sat down with GamesBeat to talk about Wolfenstein Youngblood and discuss the new characters, BJ Blazkowicz, twin daughters Jess and Soph, the game's length, and more. GamesBeat asked Gustafsson just how long Wolfenstein Youngblood is, to which Gustafsson said the game is the studio's, quote, biggest game yet, but it's a pretty short production time, end quote. Gustafsson continued to say, quote, I think we're looking at least 25 to 30 hours if you play through everything, end quote. He added that the level progression and non-linear narrative makes the game longer than the previous titles. Game length statistic cite How Long to Beat reports that Wolfenstein New Order and Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus both have main storylines that take 11 hours to finish. So there you have it, gamers. This is one of my favorite games coming out of E3 2019, and I cannot wait to jump into that sweet Wolfenstein action co-op style with my best friends out there. And Gustafsson saying it's going to take 25 to 30 hours to complete if we do everything. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait for all of the memories, all the time that I'm going to spend in Wolfenstein Youngblood. Story number two, Google Stadia will let you change your username at any time. This story from IGN.com by Joseph Noop. The story reads, Stadia, Google's foray into the home console / streaming market, will allow users to change their names at any time they want, according to a Google spokesperson. In a report originally by PC Games N, Google confirmed that it has adopted a naming service that will allow users to change their on-screen ID so long as the name they want isn't already taken by another user. Whew, that's some good news coming out of the Google Stadia camp because, man, I don't want to be stuck with Bong Ripper 69 anymore or Poopy Pants McGee. I just want to be Snowbike Mike, and if I want to change my name to maybe Snow Mike Bike, I don't care. I just want to make sure I can change my name at any time, and I like the stance that Google Stadia is taking right now. Reminds me of one of my favorite consoles. Oh, yeah, that's right, Xbox, allowing me to change my name at any time that I want. So long that the name isn't taken. So let me know, have you ever been stuck with a bad online ID? Give me some of those bad names in the comment section. Story number three, Monster Hunter World Iceborne PlayStation 4 beta dates announced. This story from IGN.com by Tom Marks. The story reads, Monster Hunter World's massive upcoming Iceborne expansion is still 3 months away, but PlayStation 4 players will be able to jump into an open beta as early as next week. The first beta will be exclusive to PlayStation Plus subscribers and take place from June 21st to June 24th. All PlayStation 4 players then will be able to join a second beta the following week from June 28th to July 1st. Better still, you won't need to own Monster Hunter World to join in the beta, and preloading will be available in the days leading up to each beta session. The beta will give players access to 3 quests, an intro-level Great Jagras fight, and then 2 harder quests in the new Hoarfrost Reach area against either the all-new Banaboro or the returning Tigress. So, Monster Hunter fans, here's some fun ones for you. You don't gotta wait 3 months. You can jump into a beta later this month, heading into July, 2 beta sessions to play Monster Hunter Iceborne. Will I grab my parka? Will I put that cute cat out in the snow and hunt down some awesome monsters with my crew? Probably, maybe not, kind of. It looks so good, and E3 had this awesome giant ice dragon, and I really said to myself, I gotta get back into Monster Hunter World. I just don't know if this is gonna be the thing to crack me, but if you're a Monster Hunter fan, guess what? If you're playing on PlayStation 4, beta dates coming your way. Make sure to jump in. our final story for your Tuesday. Story number four, Dr. Mario World gets a release date. This story from IGN.com by Matt Perslow. The story reads, Nintendo has announced that Dr. Mario World, the developer's next mobile game, will be released on July 10th. In Dr. Mario World, players will have to eliminate viruses by matching capsules with viruses of the same color. Alongside Mario, players will also be able to call on Dr. Peach, Dr. Bowser, Dr. Toad, and a variety of other characters in order to draw on a variety of antiviral skills. Accompanying the main stage mode is a versus mode where players can go head-to-head online. Dr. Mario World is described as a free-to-start, and the initial launch contains over 200 stages with additional stages, worlds, and doctors due to be added later. So, a little fun mobile game coming your way, Nintendo. Gonna hit you with Dr. Mario World. I need somebody to hit me with some antiviral skills, because I am dying from this E3 crud. But a fun Nintendo phone game coming your way. I'm excited to see what it's all about. I'm sure it will be kind of like a Candy Crush, a match type game. It looks like it's going to be reversed. Instead of the pills dropping downward on your screen, they're actually going to go upwards on your screen. So we'll see if that changes the gameplay variety. A little head-to-head mode will be fun when I take on all my best friends on some plane rides or maybe in the back of the car. I don't know, but Dr. Mario World coming to you real soon on July 10th. And with that, that has been your After Work Recap for Tuesday, June 18th, 2019. It's your boy, Snowbike Mike, reminding you, if you liked any of the gaming headlines that I brought to you today, please go to the show description below, give those article links a click, and support those incredible games journalists around the globe. You have now been caught up for your Tuesday. I will be back for your Hump Day Wednesday recap. Have a good one, gamers.